Hello everyone, and welcome to Sign of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and the time has come for the second video in our series covering polynomial long division. If you're just starting to learn about polynomial long division, then I recommend that you watch the first video in the series by clicking on the link above. However, if you are ready for something with a little more kick to it, as can be seen by our Shisa meter, then this is the video for you. The reason I say that this polynomial division has more kick to it is because we notice the divisor has a coefficient of 2 in front of the x, while the dividend is missing a term that contains an x. Not to worry though, we can still carry out this long division process by repeating those 4 very simple steps. And remember, there is a mnemonic that goes dirty, monkeys smell bad, where the first letter of each of those words helps us to remember those steps, which are divide, multiply, subtract, and bring down. Let's begin by writing the dividend under the long division symbol. And since there is no x in the dividend, it is important for us to create a placeholder where we can simply write 0x. And remember, we need to imagine that there are virtual columns that separate the terms of the dividend. Now we scan the dividend to find its highest power of x, which turns out to be 2x cubed. And then we scan the divisor for its highest power of x, which turns out to be 2x. Time for step 1, divide. We take that 2x cubed and we divide by 2x in order to give us x squared, which we put above the long division symbol in the column reserved for x squareds. Time for step 2, multiply. We take that x squared and we multiply by 2x plus 1, which gives us 2x cubed plus x squared, which we put in the appropriate columns in a new line below the long division symbol. Time for step 3, subtract. We take the terms in the dividend and we subtract the terms that we have just written below it, working with each column separately. Before we do the subtraction, we draw a line under 2x cubed plus x squared and we put the results of the subtraction below that line. Starting in the first column, 2x cubed subtract 2x cubed gives us 0x cubed, but it's not necessary to write this down. And then in the next column, we have 29x squared subtract x squared gives us 28x squared. To the right of that x squared, we notice it is blank, which brings us onto step 4, bring down. We simply take that 0x and bring it down. We have now cycled through the steps once, but we are not done yet. In fact, we have to go through these steps all over again. So let's do it. Step 1, divide. We take 28x squared and we divide by 2x in order to give us 14x, which we write above the long division symbol in the column reserved for x's. And then step 2, multiply. We take that 14x and we multiply by 2x plus 1 in order to give us 28x squared plus 14x, which we write in a new line with each term in its appropriate column. And then onto step 3, subtract. We take 28x squared subtract 28x squared, which gives us 0x squared, but it's not necessary to write that down. And then 0x subtract 14x gives us negative 14x, which we write in a new line. However, we notice that there is no term to the right of 14x, which brings us onto step 4, bring down. We simply take that negative 4 and bring it down and write it alongside negative 14x. If you thought we were done, think again. We actually have to follow these steps one more time. So let's do it. Step 1, divide. Negative 14x divided by 2x gives us negative 7. Step 2, multiply. Negative 7 multiplied by 2x plus 1 gives us negative 14x minus 7. Step 3, subtract. negative 14x subtract negative 14x gives us 0x, which is not necessary for us to write down. And then negative 4 subtract negative 7 gives us positive 3. Step 4, bring down. There is nothing more to bring down, which means that we have finally reached the end of our calculations. The result of the division is x squared plus 14x minus 7, which we refer to as the quotient, while the 3 at the bottom of our calculations is referred to as the remainder. And what this really means is when we take the dividend and we divide it by 2x plus 1, our result is x squared plus 14x minus 7 with a remainder of 3. In other words, the dividend can be written as 2x plus 1 multiplied by x squared plus 14x minus 7 plus the remainder of 3. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video, then please let me know. If you like this level of spiciness, then try out this question and let me know what your answer is in the comments below. If you're looking for even more spiciness, then be sure to check out the next video in this series. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.